We have explained the dua before the Fatiha, the dua in the ruku', dua after ruku', dua in the sujood, dua between the two sajda. Then we did the tahiyyat, the salat al-ibrahimiyya, and today there's a gift, literally, a gift from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith is in Bukhari and in Muslim, muttafaq alayh. After Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught us the tahiyyat and the hadith of the tahiyyat. At the end of the hadith, listen to what he said. ثُمَّ لِيَتَخَيَّرْ مِنَ الدُّعَاءَ أَعْجَبَهُ إِلَيْهِ وَيَدْعُوا. After you finish the tahiyyat, after you finish salat ala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, many people, innaka hamidun majid, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Habibi, you are missing a great opportunity and you are missing the gift from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because at that time, and the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, he said, the musalli, the person who's praying, when he finished, innaka hamidun majid, let him, let her choose any dua she or he likes and make it. Allahu Akbar. From the dunya and from the akhirah. From the matters of dunya and from the matters of the akhirah. So let's make it a habit. Inshallah, you're doing this already. But if not, make sure that you do not make a salam before you make a dua. I'm going to give three duas, inshallah ta'ala. Authentic dua. One from the best man ever created. Second is from the next best man. And third from a sahabi. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that when you finish your salat, فَلْيَسْتَعِذْ. Let everybody make isti'adha, ask Allah to protect them from four things. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min azaabi jahannam wa min azaabi al-qabr wa min fitnati al-mahya wal-mamat wa min sharri fitnati al-masih al-dajjal. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to seek refuge from the punishment of jahannam, from the punishment of the grave, from the punishment or from the fitna of life and death. What does that mean? Fitna al-hayat, fitna the fitna of life, is all the fitna. يعني, ya Allah, protect me from being or from falling into the traps of my desires. Protect me from any doubts in my deen. Protect me from dalal. Protect me from anything. This is the fitna of the hayat. وفتنة الممات, and protect me from the fitna on my deathbed. On my deathbed, the shaitan does not give up. This is the most time the shaitan wants to work so hard, because he's about to lose you. He's about to lose that person and he's going to die on iman. So this is the most time he whispers. So every single salat, I'm asking Allah to protect me from that fitna when I'm about to die. And the last fitna, from the evil of the fitna of the Dajjal. Now, second dua, and wallahi, every time I hear this dua, I feel like I did not understand my deen. Abu Bakr, who's Abu Bakr? Mubashshar bil Jannah, the father-in-law of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first khalifa, declared by all scholars unanimously the best man after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His iman, if it's put in one scale, and the iman of the whole ummah in the other scale, it will overweigh. He came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and please, I want you to imagine, what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teach him? He said, ya Rasulullah, teach me a dua to say in my salat. Who's asking? Abu Bakr. Asking who? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what did he tell him to say? اللهم يا أبو بكر say, اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر. If Abu Bakr has wronged himself ظلما كثيرا, and who's teaching him? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ya Abu Bakr, say, I, Abu Bakr, wronged myself a lot. يعني, if Mubashshar bil Jannah wronged himself a lot, what did this abd say? What do I say? اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. No one forgives the sins except you. So يا الله, please forgive me and have mercy on me because you are the all forgiving, the all merciful. Wallahi, sometimes I say, if Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم tell me you are مبشر بالجنة, what do I do? I feel like, Allah ya shabab, we're done. Alhamdulillah. No, with this bushara from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني guaranteed, he told him to say, I have wronged myself. Abu Bakr wronged himself, the one who gave half of his wealth, I mean all his wealth to the deen. Wronged himself. Third and last one, and maybe next week we'll give a couple more, because this is in a very important time that many people ignore. They just say salam, and it's extremely important to make dua. A man, sahabi, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saw him say something when he finished, before he finished the salat. He said, what did you say? He said, Ya Rasulullah, inni la uhsinu dandanataka wala dandanat mu'adh. Ya Rasulullah, I do not know the dandana, your dandana, and the dandana of Mu'adh. What does dandana mean? Dandana means when you hear something, but you do not understand what it means. يعني يا رسول الله, this dua that you make and the dua that Mu'adh make, huge, long, very, you know, eloquent. I'm a simple man. I do not know how to say such a beautiful words. But before I continue, why did he choose Mu'adh? He had something in his heart against Mu'adh, that sahabi. Why? Mu'adh radiyallahu an used to pray with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the fard of Isha, and then he used to go to his qawm and pray with them Isha again, but with the intention of sunnah, and they are praying Isha because they want him to lead them in salat. So one time Mu'adh came and led the people in the salat. Allahu Akbar, alif lam mim. Not Surah Ibrahim that the Sheikh recited. He started with the Baqarah. He kept on going and going and going. So this man was sitting in the crowd and he was exhausted. So he left the Salat. He prayed alone and went. After he finished, they went to Mu'adh and told him, so and so left the Salat and prayed on his own. So Mu'adh said, إِنَّهُ munafiq. He is munafiq. This man was so furious. He went to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I come exhausted from work. And you could imagine, it's 105 degrees, and we are in and out of the air condition. We only stay outside for 2-3 minutes, and we complain. They are working in Medina in 120 degrees outside all the time. No air condition, no nothing. So Ya Rasulullah, I come exhausted. And Mu'adh is reading Baqarah in Isha. So I prayed alone. He called me munafiq. Call Mu'adh to come here. And this is where the term came. أَفَتَّانٌ أَنْتَ يَا مُعَاذ. Ya Mu'adh, are you creating a fitna in your community? He said, what did I do, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Al-Baqarah? What's wrong with الشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى. We're reading Baqarah. People are exhausted. And he reprimanded him for saying, for calling him a munafiq, because it's a long story. This man died as a shaheed. He died as a shaheed in one of the battles. So he has something against Mu'adh. That's why he said, Ya Rasulullah, I do not know the dandana, your dandana and the dandana of Mu'adh. All I know is, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah wa a'udhu bika min an-nar. All I know how to say, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Allah, I ask you jannah, and Ya Allah, keep me from the hellfire. What did the teacher of this ummah tell this man? حولها ندندن. He said, everything that you hear me and Mu'adh say, all those big stuff, at the end of the day, they land in your dua. At the end of the day, whatever you see us say, at the end of the day, we are all asking for Jannah and saving us from the hellfire. حولها ندندن. Around what you said, you're hearing all these words. So, Ya Akhwan, even if you... ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسن وفي الآخرة حسن. Right? Amazing, amazing, beautiful dua from the Quran. Or like the simple man said, اللهم إني أسألك الجنة وأعوذ بك من النار. But do not let that time go without making a sincere dua.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيماً.